In this video, we are going to see a problem based on two wattmeter method to measure three phase power. So the statement of problem is like this. Three coils, each having a resistance of 8 ohm and inductance of 0.02 Henry respectively, are connected in A star and B delta across three phase 400 volt 50 cycle per second supply. Calculate the readings of two wattmeter connected suitably to measure the total power absorbed by the above star and delta connected load. Also calculate the power factor of the circuit. So let's solve. They are given three coils. That means it's an inductive circuit whose resistance is 8 ohm and inductance is 0.02 Henry. This is connected in star first and then in delta across three phase 400 volt 50 cycle per second supply. So line voltage is 400 volt and frequency is 50 cycle per second, or you can consider 50 hertz. What we are supposed to obtain is readings of two wattmeter and power factor of the circuit. So let's solve. First of all, let's calculate the value of ZPH, which is R plus JXL. R is 8 plus JXL is 2 pi FL. F is 50 and L is 0.02. So if you solve, you will get ZPH equal to 10.1724 at an angle 38.15 degree ohm. So what we have done, we have calculated ZPH, because irrespective of a connection, either star or delta, ZPH value will always remain same. Now once we got a ZPH, we know first it's a star connected load. So for a star connection load, we know phase voltage equal to line voltage divided by root 3. Line voltage is 400 volt. So 400 divided by root 3. So what is the phase voltage we are obtaining? So phase voltage we will get as 230.9401 volt. Now VPH we calculated, ZPH is also known to us, we can get IPH. So IPH is a phase current, nothing but VPH upon ZPH. So this is equal to 230.9401. And ZPH is 10.1724. So IPH equal to 22.7025 ampere. It's a star connected load. What does that mean? In a star connected load, line current equal to phase current. Hence, I can say line current IL equal to 22.7025 ampere. Now, we should know what is the value of phi. Phi is nothing but angle of ZPH. So, in this case, it is 38.15. So, phi is 38.15 degree. Now all the things are known to us to use a formula of W1 and W2. So it's an inductive circuit because they have given three similar coils. So coil means it's an inductive circuit. So for inductive circuit, W1 equal to VLIL cos 30 minus 5. Hence W1 equal to VL is 400 multiplied by IL 22.7025 multiplied by cos 30 minus, what is the value of phi? 38.15. If you solve, you will get wattmeter 1 reading W1 equal to 8.9893 kilowatt. And what about W2? It is very simple. W2 equal to VL IL cos 30 plus 5. So W2 equal to 400 multiplied by 22.7025 multiplied by cos 30 plus 38.15. So if you solve, you will get W2 as 3.3797 kilowatt. Once we know W1 and W2, we can calculate total power consumed equal to W1 plus W2. So if I substitute the value of W1 and W2, what I will get? P equal to 12.369 kilowatt. You can get a power factor also. It's very simple. Power factor is cos 5, and phi we have already calculated, which is nothing but angle of ZPH. So it's a cos 38.15 degree. So power factor is 0.7864. Nature will be lagging because it's a coil given, and coil is nothing but inductive circuit. So this is the first part of a problem. Let's go to the second part. So in second part, what they are saying, the load is now connected in delta. So for a delta connected load, we know phase voltage equal to line voltage. Line voltage is given as 400 volt. Hence, for delta connected load, phase voltage will also be 400 volt. Now, ZPH will also remain same. So, ZPH we have already calculated as 10.1724 at an angle 38.15 degree ohm. Why we need ZPH? In order to calculate IPH. So IPH will be VPH divided by ZPH. VPH is 400, ZPH is 10.1724. So if you solve, you will get phase current equal to 39.3221 ampere. Now it's a delta connected load, so I can say line current is root 3 phase current. It's root 3 multiplied by 39.3221. So line current will be 68.1079 ampere. Now we can get W1 and W2. So W1 is VL IL cos 30 minus 5. VL over here is 400. IL is 68.1079 multiplied by cos 30 minus 5 is 38.15 degree. So if we solve, you will get wattmeter 1 reading as 26.968 kilowatt. Similarly, I can get W2. So W2 will be VL IL cos 30 plus 5. So W2 will be 400 multiplied by 68.1079 multiplied by cos 30 plus 38.15. Solution of this will give you W2 equal to 10.1393 kilowatt. If I know W1 and W2, I can say total power equal to W1 plus W2. So if you add readings of W1 and W2, you will get total power P equal to 37.1073 kilowatt. Since I am not changing any R or L in a phase, hence whether it is star or delta connected load, phi will remain same, hence power factor will also remain same. So power factor is cos phi. Phi is nothing but 38.15. Solution will give you answer equal to 0.7864. Being an inductive coil, nature of power factor will be lagging. This is the required answer. Thank you.